Samudra Manthan is one of the best known events in Hindu mythology narrated in Vishnu Purana and Bhagavata Purana. Samudra Manthan explains the origin of Amruta, the heavenly nectar of immortality. The event has many aspects to it, such as the incarnation of Lord Vishnu as Kurma Avatar and drinking of poison by Lord Shiva. In today's video, we will share with you the story of Samudra Manthan and the consequences of this important event. So keep watching till the end. Once Indradev, while riding on his elephant, came across sage Durvasa. Sage Durvasa offered Indra a special garland given to him by a nymph. Indra accepted the gift and placed it on the trunk of the elephant as a test to prove that he was not an egoistic deva. The flowers on the garland had a scent that attracted some bees. Annoyed by the bees, Airavata threw the garland on the ground. This enraged the sage, as the garland was a dwelling of fortune and was to be treated as a prasada. Durvasa cursed Indra and all devas to be bereft of all strength, energy and fortune. In battles following the incident, the devas were defeated and the asuras led by Bali gained control over the universe. The devas went to seek help from Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu advised them to approach the situation in a diplomatic manner. The devas formed an alliance with the asuras to jointly churn the ocean for the nectar of immortality and to share it among themselves. However, Vishnu told the devas that he would arrange for them alone to obtain the nectar. The churning of the ocean of milk was an extensive process. Mount Mandara was used as a churning rod. Vasuki, a Nagaraja who abides on Shiva's neck, became the churning rope. First, the devas held the head end of the snake while the asuras held the tail end. The asuras were enraged by this, as the lower part of an animal is less pure than the part that contains the head. They insisted on holding the head side of the snake. Lord Indra had an inkling that his reverse psychology would work. The asuras demanded to hold the head of the snake, while the devas, taking advice from Lord Indra, agreed to hold its tail. The head part of the Vasuki was held by the asuras and the tail part was held by the devas. When the mountain was placed in the ocean, it began to sink. Vishnu, in the form of Kurma, also known as a turtle, came to their rescue and supported the mountain on his shell. The devas and the asuras pulled back and forth on the snake's body alternately, causing the mountain to rotate, which in turn churned the ocean. The devas and asuras were poisoned by fumes emitted by the snake Vasuki. The devas then approached Lord Shiva for protection. Lord Shiva consumed the poison to protect the three worlds, and in the process, his throat turned blue. He was henceforth called Neelakantha, or the blue-throated one. All kinds of herbs were cast into the ocean and 14 ratnas or treasures were produced from it. They were divided between the asuras and the devas. There were two goddesses which emerged from the ocean. Goddess Lakshmi. Lakshmi, the devi of fortune and health, emerged from the cosmic ocean draped in a red and gold sari. She accepted Lord Vishnu as her eternal consort. Apsaras. Apsaras like Rambha and Menaka emerged from the ocean. They chose the Gandharvas as their companions. Gandharvas were the musicians in the court of Indradev and Apsaras were the dancing beauties. Three types of supernatural animals appeared. Kamadhenu. Kamadhenu, the wish-granting cow, was taken by Brahma and given to the sages so that the ghee from her milk could be used for yajna and similar rituals. Airavata. Airavata and several other elephants that emerged were taken by Indradev. The elephant Airavata is said to be the protector of all directions and is also said to connect the earth with the sky. Uchchaishravas. Uchchaishravas was a seven-headed horse that was given to the Asura king Bali. Snow white in color, the horse is said to be the king of all horses. Three valuables were also produced. Kaustubhamani. Kaustubha Mani is the most valuable divine jewel in the world that is embedded in the necklace worn by Vishnu. Parijata. From the depths of the ocean sprung a divine flowering tree called Parijata. The flowers of the tree never fade or wilt. Indradev decided to take the magnificent flowering tree to Devlok. In Hinduism, it is forbidden to pluck Parijata flowers and only the fallen flowers can be used to worship deities. Sharanga. Sharanga was one of the two divine bows crafted by Vishwakarma. Lord Vishnu used this bow in his Parashurama, Rama and Krishna avatars. Additionally, the following were produced. Chandra. The moon god Chandra appeared as one of the precious ratnas and took refuge in the matted head of Lord Shiva. Dhanvantari. Dhanvantari emerged from the ocean holding a pot of Amrut. He is known to be the god of physicians and is responsible for teaching ancient medicine. He is also known as the father of Ayurveda. Halahala. Halahala was the poison from snake Vasuki that was swallowed by Lord Shiva. Shankha. Shankha or Panchajanya conch was taken by Lord Vishnu. In ancient times, the sound of the conch signified the beginning of the war. Kalpavriksha. Kalpavriksha emerged from the ocean and is said to be a divine wish-fulfilling tree. Amrita. At last, Amrita emerged in a pot held by Dhanvantari. It is a heavenly nectar of immortality. Fierce fighting ensued between the Devas and the Asuras for it. To protect it from the Asuras, Garuda took the pot and flew away from the battlefield. The Devas appealed to Vishnu, who took the form of Mohini. As a beautiful and enchanting damsel, she distracted the Asuras and took the Amrita. She then distributed it among the Devas who drank it. An Asura named Swarabhanu disguised himself as a Deva and drank some nectar. Mohini noticed his disguise and before the nectar could pass the Asura's throat, cut off his head with her Sudarshan Chakra. From that day, his head was called Rahu and his body Ketu, which both later became planets. Samudra Manthan was a successful event for the Devas. The Asuras felt cheated and were eventually defeated by the Devas. Such an extensive event saw the incarnation of Lord Vishnu as Kurma Avatar, saw Lord Shiva saving the universe by keeping the poison in his throat, and saw the birth of Amrita or the divine nectar. The event teaches us the principles of respect, greed, lust, and morality. Hope you enjoyed this video and do not forget to share this with your friends and family. Until we meet next time, Shantakaram Bhujagashayanam Padmanabham Sureshan Vishwadharam Gaganasadrisham Megavarnam Shubhangam.